of the equipment you'll need for taco salad today. You'll need a frying pan or skillet, depending on the recipe. Sometimes it will call it a frying pan, sometimes a skillet. We need one of those. You need a lettuce spinner. You need a cheese grater. You're going to need your large bowl. You need your wooden spoon, cutting board, and a knife. If you're making the recipe at home, you'll want to do the side where it talks about the lettuce and the cheese. So to use, wash the lettuce. You're going to use a lettuce spinner. There's three parts: the bowl, the basket, and the lid. Break up your lettuce, put it into the basket. Hold the basket under some cold running water. Make sure you thoroughly rinse all the leaves. Shake that out a little bit. Try and put the basket right under so you don't drip water everywhere. Lid goes on. And turn the dial at the top. That's going to spin the basket inside and shake all of the water off the lettuce, making it nice and dry. Once we have it all dry, you're going to tear it into bite-sized pieces and place it into your largest bowl. Remember, don't leave the pieces this big. We want to tear them into bite-sized pieces. You don't want to cut them with a metal knife. It can cause the edges of the lettuce to rust or turn brown. So we're just going to tear them all into bite-sized pieces and put them in there. While one person in the group is working on this, someone else could be working on cutting up the onions, somebody else can be grating the cheese. Make sure that you're using your time wisely so the recipe is done efficiently. We have some rusted lettuce right here where it sort of turned brown from when it was cut in the garden. So we'll get that all out of there. So we'll have a layer on the bottom of the bowl of clean, dry lettuce that's torn into bite-sized pieces. And that's the end of that. Set that aside. If somebody has been grating the cheese, we'll just finish that up. Just watch as you get close to the end of the cheese that you slow down so you don't grate your fingers. And we've got our cheese grated. Get all of that cheese on there. And that cheese is going to get sprinkled on top of the lettuce. Step is to take our taco chips, grab a handful and just very gently crush them on top. We want them more into bite-sized pieces than the big triangles that they start with. We don't want to toss the taco salad at this point. The lettuce might still be a bit wet. If we do, then our taco chips get wet and then they start to get a little bit soggy. Alright, somebody else has been cutting up the onions. Remember, flat side down when you're using a chef's knife. Rock the knife, keep your fingers away from the edge. We want to cut the onions just into a small or fine dice, so chop them up nice and small. We're going to add those into the pan with the ground beef. We're going to cook the ground beef until it's all brown. And then we're going to add our salsa, then our chili powder, our cumin, and our salt. And after that's cooked for a while, we're going to reduce the heat and we're going to add some sour cream just at the end and then combine the ingredients. Our stovetop on medium. We have a large pan, so it's on a large element. Make sure you match the element size to the pan size. I'm going to add my cut onions into the ground beef. Using a wooden spoon, I'm going to break up the ground beef. And this is where we want to cook it until it all turns brown. Once it's all brown, once again, we'll add our other ingredients. All right, so the ground beef is almost brown. When you're cooking it, just keep breaking up those big pieces. Make sure that it's brown all the way through. Remember we talked about with steak, it can be pink inside, but once it's done into ground, it's ground up, we need to make sure that it's brown all the way through. If it was a hamburger, you would use a meat thermometer, check to make sure that it's 71 degrees Celsius in the center. When it's put onto a clean plate, you want to make sure that the juices are all running clear. It's a little bit hard to see the juice color here because of the color of the pan. Still a bit of red, so we just want to keep cooking that. I still see a bit of pink on some of the pieces. Once again, try and keep everything on a flat level. We don't want to pile it up in the center. We want to make sure all the meat's getting even heat. There is the chance that we could overcook the ground beef. It gets dry, so we just want to watch it at all times. Not cook it too high. We don't want to get the outside cooked and the inside still raw. So we're still keeping it on medium heat. Our onions are cooking alongside with it. All right, there's no more pink left in the meat. So our next step is to reduce the heat. And then we're going to add on our salsa and our spices. Just a reminder not to add dry spices in a hot pan. You always want to make sure there's a liquid as well. If we add certain dry spices into a hot pan, it can release oils into the air. And it almost has a pepper spray effect where your eyes start to water, your nose may start to run, you'll start to cough, it might be hard to breathe. You want to make sure you open all the windows and get away from the stove at that point because it can cause some breathing issues. So I've reduced the heat. I'm going to add in the salsa. And along with that, I'll add in the dry spices. So I've added it with liquid so we won't have a problem. I'm going to stir all of that together. Make sure you mix the salsa in with the meat mixture. Get all the spices mixed in as well. We'll get that all stirred up so we don't have clumps of salsa or clumps of meat that don't have any salsa or spices on it. And just before you're ready to serve, you're going to add in the sour cream. And we'll stir this in now. And this is what's going to make almost a dressing for our taco salad. We want to cook this until the sour cream gets hot as well. And the idea behind the taco salad is you have the cold ingredients with the combination of the hot ingredients. So it's important that you do eat it right away. It's not a salad that you can put into the fridge and eat later. The salad will wilt. And we do want to have the mixture of the hot and the cold. So I'm just going to let this heat up for a bit until I start to see it bubbling a bit and I see some steam coming off of it, then I know the sour cream is hot enough. Cook it for a couple of minutes. Again, I'm trying to make sure it's a level, all the meat mixture is level, it's not piled up in the center. Give that a minute or two. All right, so this is nice and hot. We're going to combine it, turn off your stove, and combine it with the lettuce and the taco chips and the cheese. So we'll add the meat mixture in, all on top. And then we'll gently toss the ingredients together. We don't want to stir it, we don't want to break up the chips anymore. So just gently toss the ingredients together until the meat mixture coats the lettuce. We want that well combined. And there we have your taco salad.